Hello and welcome to Gastro Pup. I'm Nishant and I'm here to show you how to make healthy, easy, yummy recipes for your pets right at home, be it a dog, a cat, or even your spouse. So today we are going to talk about soul food. For me, that's rajma chawal or fried chicken, and I've always thought, why don't my pets have that? And that's what we're going to do today. Stay tuned to find out more. So when it comes to soul food for dogs, I thought gruel would hit just the right spot for a dog. Now gruel is just a basic stew with rice, meat and vegetables. Here's what you're going to need. I have about a kg of chicken here. Now you could buy boneless chicken straight from the market, but I've got the meat on the bone because I want to take out all that goodness from the bone and the cartilage. So I'm going to take the chicken and I'm going to put it into the water, which is already boiling. I'm using about 2 liters of water here. Cover that. So while the chicken is boiling, I'm going to show you the veggies that you're going to need. I have about 3 to 4 good-sized carrots and about 3 to 4 good-sized sweet potatoes. About 2 cups of peas. I had some parsley lying around in the fridge. Now it's really good for your dog's breath, so I'm going to use that. And about 1 cup of red rice. Now you can use any rice, but I'm going to use this one because it's slightly healthier. So I'm going to clean the vegetables now. Now when you're cooking for your pet, I don't want you to peel the vegetables. It's going to lose a lot of nutrition that way. I'd rather you use a scrubber to take out all that dirt from the nooks and crannies, especially the sweet potatoes. Scrub it till you see the pink of the skin. It should look something like this. The carrots are much easier. When it comes to pets, it's all about the taste. So if your dog sees an unpeeled carrot, he's not going to send the dish back to the chef. There, that's done. I'm going to chop the veggies now. Roughly, about 1/2 inch slices should be fine. Like I said before, dogs love carrots and it's really good for their eyesight. The chicken is cooking nicely. I'm going to strain that chicken and I'm not going to throw the water away. Instead, we're going to use that water to cook the veggies and the rice. So we're going to put the potatoes and the carrots into a bowl, make space for the parsley. I've already washed them. You just need to bunch it all together and just chop roughly. Just 4 or 5 quick chops and you're done. And now let's check on a chicken. Yeah, it's done. All I'm going to do now is take out all the crud that has formed at the top. Don't really need this. Keep taking it out till the liquid runs clear. Yeah, almost done. So now I'm going to strain the chicken. And we've cooked it so it's easier for me to strip the meat off the bone. Be careful. Remember, do not throw away this water. Now, I'm going to wait for this chicken to cool for a while before I start stripping the meat off the bone. So, while the chicken cools, I'm going to cook the veggies and the rice. just going to empty out the chicken. You can see the meat has been nicely cooked. Now remember, you can leave the neck bones intact. Your dog will love them. Doesn't hurt him at all. You put the stock water back into the pot. Again, be careful. And now all you have to do is empty the veggies and the rice into the stock. And lastly, the rice. Please remember, there's no such thing as al dente when you're cooking rice for your pets. It needs to be mushy. Even if it's a little undercooked, it could give them a tummy ache. Cover that and we're almost done. So the chicken has cooled down and I'm going to start skinning it. Be really careful that you don't leave any bones behind. The cartilage of the leg piece is really good for your pet, so try taking that off. There you go. Going to take a while, but I promise you it's better than boneless chicken. It'll be a lot more tastier too. So the chicken's been all deboned and what you're left with is this beautiful whole chicken, which I'm going to now put in the pot. Done. Now all you have to do is cover it about half, leave some space open, and now let this boil for about 2 hours. Remember to put this on simmer. Keep checking back. What we're looking for here is a soupy consistency. So if you see the water disappearing, just keep adding about half a cup to a cup now and then. So it's been 2 hours and I can already smell that it's done. Let's just check, shall we? And it is. I'm just going to give it a good mix. And I can see that all the carrots and sweet potatoes are all soft and nice. There's a nice soup-like consistency to it. I'm going to turn this off. And now let's find out if our food critic in residence, Zizu, the golden retriever, thinks that our gruel is soul food or not. Now let's find out if Zizu likes the gruel. Zizu. Yep, he likes it. Yes. So if you like this recipe as much as Zizu did, please share it with your friends who have pets. If you like this video, please give us a like. And if you have any comments or questions, we would love to hear from you. For more such recipes, follow us on the Gastro Pup channel on YouTube.